Hi everyone, welcome to Naresh Technologies. This is Srinivas. So in the last session we have discussed that how to construct a two-dimensional array in a NumPy. So now in this session, how to get the submatrix using slicing concept. So we know how generally how to process elements through indexing or slicing. So indexing is used to process the elements one by one, whereas slicing means within the given bounds, we can get the elements. Here, how to get the submatrix? Matrix means we are specifying with the number of rows and columns. And here it is, we can construct the NumPy matrix by specifying the number of rows and columns using shape. So first, I'll construct one matrix. Here, we are importing the module called NumPy. I just want to construct with a predefined set of elements. For example, I'm taking one list. Using the nested list, we are constructing the NumPy array. Here, the list, the first element is in the form of row like 10, 20, 30. And the second element is 40, 50, 60. Third element is 70, 80, 90. So we are constructing using that NumPy array, not ND array. It's like ND array, n-dimensional array is used to construct an array without elements. Here it is from the list if you want to construct the array. So directly we use that array and we are passing list as an input. So we are getting that array that we can call it as a matrix. So first I'll show you. So by displaying how it will be, just print matrix. So we are printing this information. It will show in the form of rows and columns. We are executing. From OS environment. I have saved on my desktop. Here it is a Python practice.py is a source file name. And it will display the elements. First row, second row, and third row. Now, how can we get the submatrix using slicing concept? So slicing means what? We need to specify the lower bound and upper bound. But here it is a number of rows and number of columns are present. So while specifying the number of rows, lower bound and upper bound, and in case of the columns also, a lower bound and upper bound we need to specify. For example, the syntax is like this. Here, the syntax we are writing in the comments. As a slicing, we are representing like this, comma, comma. Here it is a row, lower bound, colon, row, upper bound, And here it is followed by colon, column, lower bound. And next one, here it is a column, upper bound. So this is the syntax used to process the elements, through slicing concept. Here we are printing the matrix. How to get the matrix means, suppose matrix of, we are not giving that bounds. If you are not giving the bounds, then what will happen? We know already. It will start from the beginning and up to that end, it will collect. So that we are collecting into a resultant matrix, RES, and we are just printing that result. A resultant matrix we are printing. So whenever we are executing, look at the second one. So everything it will display because we are not specifying the lower bound as well as upper bound. Suppose here, so I just want to display by giving the bounds. Here again, the result equal to matrix of that lower bound is 0, upper bound is 3. 3 means what? Up to 2 it will give. Here it is indexing 0, 1, 2. And here it is columns also. Here it is number of rows and number of columns. 0 to 3 we are giving like this. The same thing you will get. Same thing. Because how the memory will be allocated for 9 elements means like this. So index starts with 0. Horizontally and as well as vertically also index is present. Here the index starts with 0 1, 2. Nothing but up to 3. If you give the 3, anyway the upper bound is excludes. So it will give that 0 is a 1 and it is a 2. It is 2. So here it is a 0 to 3 means what? 0 to 2, and here it is also 0 to 2. Like this it will execute. Here it is, sir, whenever I just want to get only this much. First 4 elements, 2 by 2 matrix means what is 0 to 2, and here it is also 0 to 2 we should give. Sir, here it is a 2 rows and 3 columns I want to get. 2 rows and 3 columns. So here it is a 0 to 2 and it is 0 to 3. This is. So for example, I just want to get the matrix like this. So index starts with 1. Here it is a row index and column index, lower bound starts with 1 and up to end. Up to end, then that last 4 elements it will display. So in different ways we can get by giving the index, nothing but bounds through slicing concept. See here it is, just we are giving that, and whenever we execute in all the 3 ways, here we are printing the result, and just for separation a line gap we are giving here, and here it is also just line gap we are giving. So whenever we are printing all these things, all the three will give the same result. For example, only 2 rows and 3 columns required. Only 2 rows and 3 columns. So here it is how we mention. This one. Here it is just 2 rows only. Nothing but 0 to 2. And 3 columns. 3 columns we are displaying. So here whenever we execute only 2 rows, look at that last result, only 2 rows and 3 columns it is specifying. Sir, for example, is a 3 rows and 2 columns required. Here it is a 3 rows and 2 columns required. 2 columns. Now we are executing. So again look at that last result here. Here it is a total 3 rows and only 2 columns it is displaying. Sir, I want to display only 50, 60, 80, 90. So from the first row, it starts with 1 and up to 3. This is. So whenever we execute and look at that last one, only 50, 60, 80, 90. So this is how we are collecting or we are constructing the submatrix. From the given matrix with the help of slicing concept. In the slicing concept, one is representing number of rows and one is representing number of columns. Here while representing the rows, what is the lower bound and what is the upper bound? While representing the columns also, what is the lower bound and what is the upper bound? So this is how we are representing and how to construct the submatrix. So hope you understood. For more videos, please subscribe to Naresh Adi channel. Thank you.